sisters. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
I want to send salutations and felicitations firstly to the Imam of our time, Imam Al-Mahdi
alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala
ali Muhammad. On the blessed beloved of Bibi Fatima Zahra, salam ala alayha.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ala.
Today is the viladat of the one who is the reason for the creation of not only the universe but also the nur of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Maula Ali alaihi salam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali
Muhammad.
Is the viladat of the reason for the Prophet's smile, the reason for Maula Ali's comfort. Is the viladat of the mother of 11 imams, the base of nubuwwat and imamah, the focal point of ismat and taharat, the leader of the women of the world, the focal point of Hadith Kisa, for whom Ayat-e-Tathir was revealed, for whom the Surah Qatar was sent as a challenge to the pagans of Makkah. If I were to list her merits and qualities, not just me, but the whole universe would run out of time. We Shias are the luckiest ones to have such immaculate and infallible personalities to look up to and follow for guidance and help. It's enough for us to be proud of the fact that we are the followers of Bibi Fatima Zahra, salamu
alaikum.
But out of the 14 masumin that Allah has blessed us with, one nur is such that even the other infallibles have taken pride to be connected to. Yes, 11 of our imams have at some point of time expressed their gratitude to Allah and felt proud of the fact that they were descendants of Bibi Fatima Zahra, salamu
alaikum.
Bibi Fatima's house was a place where angels would do tawaf, where they would feel proud to be known as servants rather than angels. Hers was the only house where the angel of death wouldn't dare enter without her permission. Angels learned to do tasbih because of Bibi Fatima. They learned to do ruku because of Bibi Fatima. They learned to do sajda because of Bibi Fatima. They learned to do zikr because of Bibi Fatima Zahra, salamu alayha. She was, is, and will always be the role model for women of the world till the Day of Judgment. If you study the life of this great personality, you'll find how she preached to Sharia through her actions. When one day a blind companion of the Prophet came to visit him, she went inside her room to observe hijab. Although the Prophet clarified that the companion was blind. To this, she replied, saying, "He cannot see me, but I can see him." This does not mean the Prophet was not aware of the matter. But this question was posed to inform the women whose chief is Bibi Fatima Zahra, salamu
alayha.
On the other hand, you'll see her march into the grounds of Mubala with her father, husband, and children when Allah needed her to save his tawheed. You'll see her confronting the illegitimate caliph who snatched her right off inheritance from her.